Welcome to Straight Line MTB, and today is new bike day, and I am very excited because it's been a little over a couple months since I had a new bike, and I'm excited to share with you guys. We're gonna unpack this box and show you what's inside. A little bit of surprise, it is something different than I'm normally riding, but it is still a mountain bike and it still rides on dirt. Unfortunately, this is take two because our original video did not work out, but I will cut to the unboxing section and we'll be right back and talk more about the bike. And there you have it. It is the brand new 2021 Nukeproof Scout 290. This is the pro version. So if you follow our channel in the past, I have ridden the Nukeproof Mega 290, and that was one of my favorite bikes that we have reviewed. So I'm very excited to try out the Scout. It's a bike that I've always wanted to try out, but it's been a while since I rode a hardtail. So I'm very, a little anxious to see how we fare on the trail. I think the last hardtail I had was 2016. It was a common Scout made at AM, but I'm very, very excited about this bike. And just first impression of looking at this bike is it is very, very high quality. I have to say it looks a lot better in person. And I know I've said this about a lot of bikes, but just that brushed gloss finish on this bike. It's a brushed aluminum with a gloss clear coat over top. Looks really, really good. Just so looking at geometry on this bike, the seat tube being very on the very slack side compared to some of the other bikes I've been riding. This bike comes in at 73 degrees and it says it's 74 and a half when it's sagged in when you're on the bike. That is really, really on the slack side for today's numbers, especially a lot of the bikes we've been riding are 78.5 with the common Scout made at AM, or even the set down to the 76 for the Ripley AF and the Ripmo AF. So it is on the slacker side, but it does help looking at the reach on this size large was a 450. I was thinking that is short, but with that slacker seat tube angle, you're gonna get more comfort in the cockpit. Feels a little bit longer than you would think for something with a steeper seat tube angle. And then also our head tube angle is at a 65 degree. It says 66.5 is when it's sagged in when you're on the bike. And then the chainstays are nice and long. I prefer a longer chainstay. These are 440 for the size large. So that should translate well onto the trail. So being the pro build kit, this is the top level build for the Scout 290, and it has a really great part spec. For the drivetrain, you're getting a SLX 12-speed group. It's got the SLX cassette with a 30-tooth front chainring, and then also obviously the 10 to 51-tooth rear cassette, SLX rear derailleur, SLX shifter, and you're getting the SLX four-piston brakes, which is, I'm a big fan of the new four piston brakes, and I'm very excited to try out the new Shimano four pistons because I've not tried them. If you watch our channel, you know I'm a big Magura fan. So I think that they have some big shoes to fill because I haven't found a brake that I liked as much. Looking at the cockpit is also really well done. I like the Nukeproof's Horizon components. The stem is a 50 millimeter Horizon stem, and it's really, it looks like a really nice stem. It's CNC machined. It's just really good to look at. And the bars are at 800 millimeter Horizon aluminum bar. I believe these are 25 millimeter rise, also another thing that looks really nice. It doesn't look like your standard house branded group components. For the dropper post, it's a Brand X Ascend, and it's a 170 millimeter dropper. And I will say that I've had about 5 or 6 of these droppers, and I know they come in at about $135 from Chain Reaction. And you know, that might be frowned upon against some of the $200, $300, $400 droppers, but I will say they have been the most consistent and reliable droppers that I have owned. So I am not sad about it. They're a little bit on the heavier side, but it is a hardtail and we're trying to smash, so not a big deal. But I will say one of the downfalls to the Brand X droppers are the dropper levers. But luckily, Nukeproof has spec'd the Shimano. It's the new Shimano dropper lever, and it feels really good. It's a lot higher quality, and it's nice to see that on this build. As far as for your fork, you get a RockShox Lyric Select. So it is the bottom line. You just get one compression dial and rebound, and obviously your air spring. Had this on the Transition Sentinel. Didn't have a lot of complaints about it. You know, it's just really a set it and forget it fork. And then looking at the wheel set, it is the DT Swiss M1900s. They're the 30 millimeter internal width wheels, 29er obviously. And they have the DT Swiss 370 hubs. Those are the opening level hubs for DT Swiss. They are a Paul system instead of the Star Ratchet. And you're getting, I believe it's 24 points of engagement in the rear. Looking at just the small things like the grip is new. The grips are Nukeproof Sam Hills. They feel real on the thin side. I like a chunkier grip, but we're gonna ride them and see how it goes. And then also the Nukeproof Horizon saddle, something else that I've never tried. I will try it out, but just like, you know, a lot of preference items on bikes, I will probably switch it out for our WTB Coda saddle. And then not to skip or forget about our tire spec, they did a really good job with some really aggressive tires on this bike. Up front, you have the Maxxis Assegai. It's a 3C and it's just the EXO casing. So you get the little bit lighter weight front casing. It's a 2.5, nice and sticky tires. But out back, I like what they did with the Dissector. It's the 2.5 and it is an EXO Plus. So you get that extra bit of armor for the rear, which is usually the problem where we're tearing or denting rims. So you get a little bit extra. So speaking of value, for $2,500, what do I think for what the package is? I think it's right where it should be. If you look at other big name brands like a Specialized or even Niner, bikes in the same category for $2,500, you're getting a lower end spec with those bikes. So I think Nukeproof is coming in, undercutting some of those bikes with a better value. I don't think it's a stellar value. I think Nukeproof's prices have creeped up a little bit in the last few years, but that's due to them making really awesome bikes. So I think they're competing well with the bigger name brands. But I'm excited because I already got my Laminex frame protection tape on this bike, because if you know, we like to keep our bikes fresh because we're going to send it to a new home after we review it. And so if you guys want to get 20% off some awesome high quality frame protection tape and help out our channel, check out the link below, click it. You can get 20% off their products. And like I said, it helps out the channel just a little bit. And I also put in our tubeless from Tanis Tubeless Armor rear tire insert. I only run one in the rear because that's really for me to save my rims. I haven't had much issue in the front. So those are another awesome item you guys can check out and get the one of the lightest tire inserts that is available right now. So I am going to take this bike out, run it through its paces. I'll be posting a first ride review and give you some more thoughts about what I think about this bike, as well as a longer term review to give you kind of a full encompassing review from our point of view. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram at straightline_MTB and straightlinemtb.com. And if you guys have any questions whatsoever, let me know in the comments down below. I will watch out for anything you want me to and answer any questions you may have. And again, thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you on the next video.